Hello fam, welcome back to another best of 2020. Today I will be walking you through some of my most loved and most used blushes. And yes, in recent past I did a video of top 5 blushes, the blushes which I bought in 2020 and I happened to share my experiences with. So do check out that video later if you want to know better. But yes, today I'm excited because I happen to see that a lot of you love my blush videos. And yes, I was a little excited for this one specifically because you people like it. So everything will be mentioned in my description if you want to grab one for yourself. So let's just get started and know some amazing blushes. Before I jump onto some powder blushes, let's talk about two cream blushes I enjoyed in 2020. One is by the Lakme Kareena Kapoor Khan Cheek Contour Blush. This is not the blush which I have used it like every month or every day, but this brush comes pretty handy for me in winters because winters is a time when it is quite drying. And I like look out for products which are into cream finishes just because they are a little non-drying and it really looks much better than any other powder blush you use it by itself if you have a super drying skin. But definitely even a powder blush would work absolutely wonderful in winters if you do your makeup right. But yes, this one in particular by Lakme I really liked using in winters. I have used this blush a lot of times. You just need a very little product. The only crunch factor I would say with the blush would be if you don't blend it well with your blender, then it may start looking patchy. It's just the blending game which has to be right with this blush. But the product is really good. It is expensive, but I have personally liked it. And this was my first ever cream product in blush family, and this really made me buy another one which I'm going to show you. So definitely something which I have enjoyed past year and I absolutely love it. I did mention about this blush in many other videos of mine, and yes, most of you said that this blush can be a little drying, but I would say if you blend it well, it is not going to be dry. Just go a little slow with the product. Since I was talking about a cream blush, as I mentioned, that cream blush by Lakme actually made me buy another cream blush because that made me feel confident with the product, the formula. And yes, I got the confidence that I can actually pull off a cream blush. So this is by Sugar Cosmetic Face Forward Blush Stick in the shade Pink Prime. Again, something very well done. As I have already mentioned that I have enjoyed their cream products, the Sugar Cosmetic cream products into this black packaging are wonderful. If you haven't tried even one so far, I think this is the time you should be grabbing one for yourself. And if you're confused what to go for, then I would suggest you to go for a corrector stick or a contour stick first and then decide what you want to buy later. But blush is definitely good. I've not used this blush a lot of time, I would say, but yes, some odd days I do like using it. The reason of me not enjoying it as much, not because of the formula, is because of the shade, because it's pretty light for my skin tone. Maybe a shade deeper would have been a best option, but the formula is really good and I have used it. You need very little product. This product is not finishing up in 1 year around, so you can use this product for 2-2.5 years because they give you a lot here. But definitely a product which I have enjoyed it and I will continue using it. Now moving on to some powder blushes. Now blushes in general does play a very important role if you do full face of makeup. I must say that, you know, there was this time that I never used to like putting blushes. For that matter, I didn't even own one single blush. But when I started using blushes, I realized that one blush, a blush on your face, when you do your full face of makeup, really makes everything together and comes get everything together basically. Because if you remove this blush from your face, you see that there's a plain face, nothing going on. It looks very pale and very blank. So include a blush if you haven't started yet, because yes, you will see a lot change in your makeup appearance and you will start loving blushes. Now moving on to one of my favorite blushes from 2019 itself, I would say, and it was introduced to me in 2019 and since then I have never stopped using this one, is the Flower Beauty Flower Pots Powder Blush. This is in the shade Wild Rose, one of my favorite shades also, and I have absolutely loved this blush. The texture is matte, it's super smooth, easy to blend, easy to work with. It has a little kickback, and I like that in any of my blushes because I feel if you have a little bit of kickback, it allows you to work with these products slowly on your face. And if you happen to pick up the product from any dense brush also accidentally or with any fluffy brush, and if the product is super pigmented and it doesn't have any kind of kickback, what happens basically if you accidentally pick up a lot of product and you apply on your face, it just settles at one place. And products which has a little bit of kickback allows you to blend. I don't mind putting my brush like 4 times in the pan, it's okay, but at least my makeup looks better. So yeah, this is one of those blushes which you should be eyeing on, and they have such amazing shades and they have more shades to choose from. Formula is good, it works pretty well, this shade in particular works really well. A lot of you every time happen to ask me, does this have any kind of shimmer? No, it is a complete matte blush, but a wonderful one by Flower Beauty. Moving on to another lovely blush, and a blush to my blush family, by Colourbar, the Cheek Illusion blush in the shade Rosy Peachy. Now this blush I did buy in 2020. I absolutely fell in love with this one. I have used this blush like a million times. I like the finish of it. This is one of the most used blushes also, because I have bought it this year. I have used it only for 7 months, and it is reached to a stage where I feel at times it will just hit the pan. So it is really done well. It has a little bit of kickback. It just allows you to blend the product well. It is pigmented. Whatever shade you see here, you see it on your face. I think it shows a little much deeper than the shade you see in the pan. The only crunch factor here was the name and the blush you see. It's Rosy Peachy. You don't see any kind of peach happening here. It's a complete pink mauve. It has a lot of mauve going on. Is a blush. It is a pretty different shade in my collection, I would say, and I really enjoy using it. Something which I feel fits to my age, the way I wear makeup, something which is not super loud, something which doesn't make me feel that I applied ton of blush, something well done, I would say. Like, even without makeup you can wear this blush, and same goes with the Flower Beauty one also. They both are very similar in their formula, so that is why one of the reasons that I absolutely love this blush. This will cost you only 650 and easily available. They have more shades in this, so if you haven't tried the Colourbar one, you should be. But I have absolutely loved this and I will continue using it. So this is one of my best purchases also of 2020. Moving on to another lovely blush, and a blush which has a very different formula altogether, a formula which I have not seen in any other brand. If you have, do let me know, I will love to try. But this is something very out of the box, and it really makes you feel as if you just come out that fresh bath and you have that nice flushy illuminating cheeks, and this blush does that for you. This is the Faces Canada Ultime Pro HD blush in the shade Rosette. This is how the blush would come. Now far also you can see that this blush has some sheen going on, and yes, it is correct, but it is not that highlighter sheen that you will apply and you will see a lot of chunk of glitter on your face. No, I don't know how they have done it, but they have done it really well, and it really gives you that nice illuminating cheeks, but not overly done. It just fits well. I feel this blush is best to be worn in winters, because it's already very drying. All of our makeup are generally matte and waterproof and non-transferable. Since everything is matte, these kind of blushes do play a very important role, because then it just gives you that nice luminosity on your face. I really like the formula on this one, and I see myself buying another shade because they have only 2. I have not tried the other shade, but since I am so obsessed with this formula altogether, I will definitely be buying one. I did buy this in, I think, this year or last year, I don't remember. But jab se ye hai mere paas, it has been my buddy, my favorite blush, and I absolutely love it. So definitely, if you haven't got this one, you should be eyeing this one by Faces Canada. Moving on to another interesting blush, and a blush which makes me buy more blushes, is the L'Oreal La Barre blush in the shade 10. It's called Play With Me. This is more of a very neutral peach tone blush. Now, I absolutely love the formula on this one. I really like the blush, and I've already mentioned about this blush in my top 5 blushes also. But now there's a story to this blush. If you happen to use this blush like a million times, and when you reach a stage when it gets completely plain, then I would say this blush will stop performing. Yes. Now it is happening. I have already used this blush a lot of times. Now I see my brush doesn't pick up a lot of product. And see, I'm doing this a lot. When I do this and then when I use my brush, you can see the shade here, then only my brush picks up the product, or else my brush doesn't pick up anything. This is the problem which I'm facing with this product also, as well as the highlighter. But if you haven't tried this blush, I would suggest to try it. Ye ek factor shuru ho jayega after some time. This I wanted to mention because I was making best of 2020 and I just thought I should be mentioning this, because you should not be surprised, like, why has it stopped working? It has not stopped working, it is that your brush is not picking up the product. So you just have to like just rub your finger a bit on the product and then your brush is good to go. But all in all, a wonderful formula. It's a matte blush, blends easily. It has a lot of kickback, I would say. It has a lot of kickback. But personally, my favorite, because I like the shade here. It's very neutral, peachy. It's not too much for your face. Even if you're a person who doesn't like to apply blushes, then this is the blush you should be going in for. Because aise shade se, when you will start, you will get comfortable and the formula is good. It will give you enough time to work with. Then you will move on and buy other blushes. But by L'Oreal, it is a good one and I really like it. If I want to repurchase this one, if it completely stops working, I will repurchase it because of the shade it has. And I like it. So yes, this is another one which I have been loving past year. So many blushes to choose from. I know you must be very confused, but watch it till the end, sit around, say, and then decide which one you want to buy later. Another one is something again interesting, again something I have absolutely loved in 2020, was the My Glam Gay Play Raspberry Blush. I loved it so much that I got another shade from it. So this is the shade Frozen Raspberry 01, and this is how the blush would come. Again, a stunning brush. It has a lot of raspberry going on. You open it, you sniff it, you will have raspberry all around you. But do not worry, because when you apply the product on your face, you don't feel any kind of raspberry scent around you. But the formula is good. Again, it's a matte blush, blends easily. Though I would say this product doesn't have any kind of kickback, but it does give you enough time to blend in your blush and it doesn't stay at one place. I love this shade so much that I happen to overdo myself all the time I pick up this blush, because I like it. I just like this shade. It's not a proper pink, it's not a proper peach, it's not something dull or nude, but somewhere in between. But it is like that pop of blush. I don't know, they have done really good on this shade, as well as another shade I own. But this one is the one I have worn the most in 2020. Amazing formula. You will get this blush only on My Glam website, so check out their website. But definitely something which I will continue using and I will continue loving, because I really enjoy using this blush. Moving on to another interesting blush of 2020, and a blush which actually made me buy another shade from the same blush range, is the Makeup Revolution Reloaded Blusher Reloaded Blushes in the shade Coral Dreams. I already own another blush from this range. This is how the blush looks. You have already seen me showing this blush. Now, I have been using this blush constantly, apart from the other shade I have. Now, this shade I picked it up pretty late, but since you can see the shade and you can relate with me and my stories that I am totally digging the peaches and the oranges, I just love these shades. I don't know, they just look wonderfully on my skin. So yes, I was eyeing this shade from the longest time and I did get it in good offer from HOK. So yes, again, a matte blush, but I feel the formula is more of a matte velvet. It doesn't have any kind of shimmer. It is a pigmented blush, But for some reason, the way it blends into the skin, the way it appears on the skin is extremely wonderful. I personally love this blush and this whole range altogether. How many ever blushes they have and highlighters. Well done, amazingly done. And these blushes merely cost you 550 rupees and you get such a huge pan. So yes, for the price, the quality and the way it shows up and the shapes they have, definitely you should be eyeing this one. I would say agar kuch nahi lena to ye definitely try kar lo, because you will just fall in love with these blushes. Something I have used it a lot. इतना ज़्यादा यूज़ किया है मैंने ब्लश को, बिकॉज मुझे ये लग रहा है कि द वन आई बॉट फर्स्ट वो इतना नहीं यूज़ किया होगा मैंने जितना आई यूज़ दिस शेड, बिकॉज आई एब्सोल्युटली लव इट. डेफिनेटली वर्थ ट्राइंग वंस. So now we are down to the last two blushes, and both the blushes are from the same brand, the ColourPop, the Fresh and Peachy and Shayla into ColourPop Whistle While You Work. Now these blushes come like this. They're normal, typical pressed powder blushes. They have more different variants, but I personally love these two shades. But the formula is same on both the blushes. They are matte blushes, very easy to blend. Again, these blushes are pigmented, but I still feel they are really like my ColourPop and the Flower Beauty blushes. The formula is pretty same and similar. So if you haven't tried the ColourPop blushes, then I think you should be trying at least one for yourself, because I really like them. They have a lot of shades to choose from and the formula is wonderfully done. Again, very easy to blend. They have a little bit of kickback, I feel, with the lighter shades. Like the pink one, the Shayla one, doesn't have any kind of kickback whatsoever. It is pigmented, but this shade is so good, so different from any other shade I own. It is a typical deep pink mauve shade which has a lot of warmer undertones going on. If you are from my skin tone or deeper than me, you will definitely enjoy this shade. So yes, this is something which you should be grabbing one. Any shade you pick up from ColourPop. I have loved the formula, that is why I have loved the shades. If you do not like the formula, you will not enjoy the shade also. Face products ka yehi hota hai. If you do not like the formula on your skin, you are not happy with it, the way it blends and work on your skin, you will not enjoy the shade. So everything comes down to the formula, and the blushes I showed you today, all the formulas are absolutely well done. I do feel a little bit of kickback in face products are okay, because then they give you enough time to work with. I hope you loved watching this best of 2020 blush video. I will be leaving down my 2019 best of blushes also in my description. You can check that later. But yes, these are some of the blushes which I have loved and used a lot in past year. I will be here soon with some more best of 2020s. Everything will be mentioned and linked in my description. Consider subscribing and following me on my Instagram @bronzinggeek. Till then, you take care and I will see you in my next one.